Welcome to my home. We're here in my kitchen. I'm here with my best friend, Devon Edgar, and we are gonna show you how to do an easy, affordable, do-it-yourself, attainable Thanksgiving. With entertaining, I know it can be really overwhelming for people, not just obviously preparing the meal, but also making your home look beautiful for your guests. And having it not be this like super overwhelming, unapproachable thing. So I wanted to talk to you a little bit on how to set a beautiful table, how to go out and see what's in your own backyard and turn it into something really pretty and festive that doesn't cost a lot of money and doesn't take a huge amount of time or planning. So this is the tablescape that we came up with for our casual Thanksgiving, and it might look like a lot at first glance, but truly I threw it together. I'm not just saying that. So in my mind, I didn't want to cover the table in a large tablecloth. This table I had custom made by a local furniture maker and designer, Christian Wu. He's incredible. And for me, this table is a piece of art, so I really didn't want to cover it with a huge tablecloth, but I think having like a textural element on a hard surface is really beautiful. So I actually found a clean bed sheet to really just drape across the table, kind of like a runner, but the fact that there was like so much fabric actually made it super beautiful and textural, and it just like, you literally just throw it on and I feel like it gives your tablescape a super casual element. Other things I did that are super low maintenance is that I actually chose not to do a charger. I didn't do a placemat, thank God for Christian Wu, because he sealed this table with a super family-friendly sealant, so my table's protected, but I just really wanted to show the beauty of the table, have it be super minimal. I did black on black plates. These are super affordable, they're from CB2, and then I hate ironing napkins. That's like the bane of my existence. So I have these linen napkins and I literally didn't iron them. I just tied them in a little knot like this on an angle, and I think it looks really casual, but the knot is kind of artistic and a little bit fun. And then my plates were feeling a little bit empty, and so I pilfered Devon's ingredient area, and she bought these beautiful pears, which are, we're actually serving pears for dessert, and she had such a good tip. Her tip was to actually just slice off a little bit of the bottom so that you can stand it up beautifully. And if you were having like a larger table with 12 people, you could even just cut a little slice and put a place card name in this. So it's a very cheap, easy way to set your table. And then in the center here, I did a mixture of foraging in my own yard. So these are from my front yard. The hydrangeas are from my backyard. I got some dried florals from my local florist, Celsia Floral. Most florists now have an offering of dried florals. You can even buy them online. I've seen them on Amazon. You can get them on Etsy. But what's great about the dried florals is that you don't have to put water in the vessel, and they literally last forever. So I could leave this place setting here for the next 3 weeks and it would look exactly like this. Another little hack that I kind of stole from my florist is buying beautiful ribbon and then just tying a ribbon around the bud and then just sort of draping the ribbon across. Again, it's like you don't need any skill to do this. It's super easy, but it kind of just looks like you've put in a little bit of extra effort. And then in the center, I built the whole thing around these two beautiful ceramic vessels. I happen to have these, but you don't need them. You could use any glass vase. These are from a local ceramic artist, Danica Casper. I love having people in my home, and I love decorating for parties and things like that. So today we're gonna show you a four-person menu so you could have an intimate Thanksgiving dinner or even just like a fall party. Obviously, the most important part is the cocktail, which Devon is very eagerly working away on. But yeah, so tell us about what you picked for Thanksgiving and why you picked it.
Sure, so going along with our theme of sort of attainable, affordable, but also sort of restaurant quality food. I picked a menu that was not very traditional because I find that Thanksgiving dinner gets very, very boring for me.
I hate turkey.
Yeah, like, I know it's always dry.
I don't like the turkey. All I want is the stuffing.
Me too. All I want is the stuffing and the potatoes, and then I can leave everything else. So, but what I wanted to do though is I wanted to create a menu that sort of still had hints of traditional Thanksgiving within the menu. So we're starting with a chicken liver pate, and then it's going to go with a cranberry relish. So the pate is very decadent and rich, and so the cranberry relish just kind of cuts that with a little bit of acidity and a little bit of sweetness, and the cranberry also goes with a traditional, more traditional
very Thanksgiving-y.
And then for the main course, we're going to do duck confit. So as one of my favorite food author calls it, counterfeit duck confit.
Yeah, duck confit sounds very, like, I think I'm a decent chef, and then you put me to shame, and duck confit for me sounds, like, so intimidating.
And you know what it is, generally, because it takes days to cook the duck in its fat, and you have to buy so much duck fat, and it's messy, and it's not cheap, and it's not very affordable. So what we're going to do today is this duck confit that you don't need any extra duck fat. It basically cooks in its own fat.
Which is amazing.
Yeah, so it's, again, not messy, very approachable. You also can find duck legs basically everywhere.
Yeah.
And then we're serving it with a root vegetable gratin. So instead of doing a mashed potato or a scalloped potato, I wanted something that was going to complement the duck, which is something with a little bit of sweetness. So we're using root vegetables. So again, it's fall, it's Thanksgiving.
I'm so excited.
Yeah, so we're using celery root and fennel and sweet potatoes, regular potatoes, and we're making this sort of beautiful root vegetable gratin. That's going to be served with some beans, and the beans, generally, I don't like green beans. They're not my favorite vegetable,
but you're making them anyways.
Well, I'm making them anyways. They're served with a parsley and garlic butter sauce, essentially.
Butter makes everything better.
It really does. Yeah, so if you're somebody else who doesn't like green beans, I promise you, you will like this recipe. And then on top of that, we always need to have salad. I feel like I have salad with every meal. And so this particular salad, it's a mesclun salad. So that's very traditionally served with duck. And then last but not least for dessert, because dinner is quite a rich dinner with the duck and the potatoes and the root vegetables, the dessert's a little bit on the lighter side. So it's a vanilla bean poached pears.
I'm so excited.
And again, pears very fall. You can find they're everywhere now. And that's sort of the cornmeal pound cake and a rosemary syrup. So again, we wanted to make sure that we weren't using one-off ingredients for every dish. So you'll notice when you look at the recipes that there are common ingredients. So we're using the rosemary in the rosemary giblet we're going to make, and the rosemary in the dessert. And there's actually gin, for example, in the duck marinade, and we're using gin in our gimlet, so you don't have to buy,
you don't have to go out and buy every single spice and ingredient that you've never had and never heard of.
Exactly. So again, very approachable. I know duck and those things can sound a bit scary, but when you look at the recipes, they're really not.
We hope that you have enjoyed this video, whether you use it for Thanksgiving or for fall entertaining. I mean, we've had a lot of fun doing it. It's like 2:40 and we've already had a cocktail and are having wine. So we really just wanted to show you that holiday entertaining can be beautiful, but you don't have to spend a lot of money. I mean, Devon was so brilliant with her menu about picking items that you can buy at any grocery store, things that are really cost effective. And same here, the only thing I really purchased was some dried florals, but the rest I foraged from my property. I have been also known to lurk through our lane with my garden shears. It's just all about celebrating the season, and I think you could do this anytime, fall or winter, and just have fun with it. So cheers and happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.